Hello, 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 and welcome to the Tall Palms Classic. Day three is traditionally moving day. I'm Luke Elvey, great to have your company, as John McCarthy and I take you through the action.
Hello, Luke, glad to be here. As our next golfer sets up their round, they're getting ready to kick things off. What's the score that they have to beat here today?
With our leader sitting at 9 under par safely in the clubhouse, they'll have to get their skates on if they want to contend this one.
Thanks, Luke. We'll talk to you in a bit. Going with the hybrid here, and this one's heading towards the green. And this putt's for birdie. And for the par. Solid putt. And starting the round off at even par. And now let's move to the second hole. And this shot's looking promising. From about 135 yards out. Going with the pitching wedge here. And about 12 feet from the cup. Ooh. This is about a 4-footer. And the par putt drops. And after that one, he'll stay at even par. And next up, we have a par 5 hole. And this is not looking promising.
and safely back onto the fairway after that one, and about 130 yards to the pin. Taking a shot with the pitching wedge, and this one's definitely heading towards the green. And this putt's for birdie. Ooh, and that was very close. Just didn't drop. And this putt is for par. And that putt drops. And as we look at the scoreboard, our leader is currently having a round of 9 under par. And now the fourth hole. Looks like a 7 iron. And heading for the green. And 18 feet to go here. For the birdie. And 1 under for the day after that hole. Okay, and here is the fifth hole. And back into the fairway after that shot, and the green is in play. Well, this is definitely heading towards the green. And to save the par. And this one is for the bogey. And the putt will drop. And that performance will put him up to even par. And moving on to the sixth here. I think he'll like that. And from 165 yards out. And going with the 7-iron on this one. And not the intended result, I'm sure, on that approach shot. Just didn't have enough club. This putt's right around a 9-footer. My gracious, that was close. And this one's for the bogey. And now we're gonna take a look at the leaderboard. And plus one on the day after that hole. Next up is a par four, folks. And from 165 yards. And here's an 8-iron. Feet to the cup. And about 10 feet to go here. Ooh. That was very close. And this putt's right around 2 feet. As we look at the scoreboard, our leader is sitting on top of things with a round of 10 under. And the eighth hole is next.
He's got to be pleased with that.
And about 185 yards to the pin. And going with the 6-iron.
And nothing wrong with that shot.
And this putt is for birdie. And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And after that hole, he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard. And now setting up for the next par 4 hole. It's looking like it's heading into the fairway. Yeah, apologies to the folks at home, but that one actually ended up in the rough.
And pretty sure he's gonna like that.
And this putt is for birdie. Ooh, unfortunate. And for the par. Finishing the hole with a solid putt.
All right, and Luke, if you're there, what are you seeing out there on the course today?
Well, it was fair to say, John, they really struggled out there. Hopefully they find something in their game before this tournament's over.
Thanks, Luke.
And now setting up for the par 4. I think we'll find some fairway here. Okay, about 165 yards to the pin. Going with the 8-iron. Unlucky on that approach shot. Not enough club on that one. And to save par. And that putt will drop. And after that one, he's unfortunately going to be moving down in the standings. And ladies and gentlemen, he's not going to like that. And now setting up for the par 4 tee off. And about 110 yards to the pin from here. Looking good. This one's about 3 feet away. And that one goes in for the bird. And that hole's going to bring him down to even par. And moving along now on the 12th hole. This is going towards the green here. And about 5 feet from the cup. And that one will drop for birdie. And he will move up on the leaderboard after that hole. And next up is the par 5. It's looking like this is bound for the short stuff. And from about 250 yards out. And about 5 feet to go here. Ooh, and it just misses. This putt's looking to be about 2 feet. And it looks like he moved down in the rankings after that hole. And now the 14th hole. Well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway. From here, 110 yards to the pin. Unlucky on that approach shot. And about 4 feet from the cup. And that one will drop for bogey. And after that hole, one over for the day. And setting up now on the 15th tee. And fantastic distance on this drive. From the 150 yard marker. And he's in the short stuff now. And this for the birdie. Nice little putt. And our leader currently sitting at 11 under par. and setting up on the 16th tee. Going with the 4-iron here. And not the best approach shot we've seen today. And just like that, that beauty of a shot out of the sand is putting par well within reach. And that par putt will drop. And he's going to stay right there at even par after that hole. And let's see what the 17th has in store. This one's close call. This could be in the rough. And he's got to be happy with that. And this one's for birdie. And finishing this hole out with a solid putt. And after that hole, 1 under for the day. Now teeing up for the final hole of the round. And I think this one's going to find the fairway. And from here, about 210 yards to the pin. Going with the 5-iron here. Yeah, not the greatest luck on that approach shot. And if this putt drops, they can save par. And with that, Luke, his round has come to an end, and gosh, he played really well out there, but you wouldn't know it by looking at that leaderboard.
I liked what I saw there, John. There was some really good stuff. But compared to the leaders, they've got a long way to go if they want to win this one. Well, on behalf of John, I'm Luke. Catch you again tomorrow.